Art is a creative visual form which leads people to create emotion and meaning through the artist's imagery. Art is a way to express thoughts and feelings of what the artist is trying to portray. Each artist's work has a story behind the art, where people can learn through the artist's portrayal or resonate the art through their own personal history. Art is unique as people can have different interpretations. It can have multiple meanings to different people. Art has many forms, which can be through painting, sculpture, literature, cinema, theater, and architecture. I will be focusing on the art form of painting. I've chosen Giovanni Segantini's Spring in the Alps, which was made in 1897, and Jean-François Millet, Man with the Hoe, made in 1860 through 1862. I will be focusing on the artist's background, focus on the art elements, and what meaning I derive through the pieces. The first artwork I've chosen to discuss is Giovanni Segantini's Spring in the Alps, which was made in 1897. Before analyzing the art piece, let's focus on the artist to try to get an understanding on why he created this piece. Segantini was born in 1858 in Arcole, Tyrol. It was once a part of Austria, but is now south of Italy. He was orphaned and was put into a reformatory for wandering the streets of Milan. A chaplain in the reformatory took notice of Segantini's drawing ability, which he was sent to art school. Eventually, in the 1890s, he spent his life settling with his family in Engadin Valley in Switzerland, where his painting took on a new dimension, and he developed his own method/technique. Segantini was known for painting the larger, grander alpine landscapes surrounding his home. Segantini began to incorporate symbolist images into these landscapes, pairing divine imagery with the stunning natural beauty. Segantini's artworks are all lived-ness experiences he has captured in the Alpine mountain village in Switzerland, where he lived and worked. The Spring in the Alps, made in 1897 by Segantini, depicts a wide-view alpine landscape near the village of Solio, which is in southern-western part of Switzerland, on the right center of the painting. In the center of the painting, we see a farm woman dressed in a blue and red peasant outfit leading two horses to a trail. It appears the horses have plowed the fields, which is meant to plant seeds, which is in the left center of the painting. Where the fields have been plowed, we see a male farmer planting seeds into the plowed field. In the distance behind him, we see three more farmers working. To the right center of the painting, we see a black and white dog sitting and watching the people on what they are working on. The background of the painting depicts mountains along with long green plains. Overall, this painting captures a day in the life of farmers in southern-western Switzerland working on a plateau in the 1890s. The Spring in the Alps elements are amazing as Segantini uses over thousands of tiny brushstrokes to create elements of form, color, and space of the painting. The form of the Spring in the Alps was created by thousands of brushstrokes, which is impressive as to how much detail is in the painting. For example, there are even birds located up in the clouds in the top of the center of the painting. On the left bottom corner, we see a dead branch with the shadow on the bottom of the dead branch. The snow-tipped mountains have lots of details with their different types of structure and how the people, animals, and view look realistic through the use of tiny brushstrokes. The color of the painting are bright colors. This is impressive because Segantini uses a mixture of many colors to create imagery. For example, the grass color he uses is green, blue, and some orange. Lastly, the space in the painting allows the viewer to expand their vision between the people, the dog, the snow-pit mountains, the clouds, and the green plains. What I derive from observing this artwork is how times have changed. Life was simple in the past. I think about back in the 1890s, people would wake up to enjoy God's creation and appreciate life outdoors. I derive this meaning because I look at my surroundings where people are distracted by technology and wanting to stay indoors. I sometimes feel regret when I must stay indoors doing homework and go to work without enjoying the outdoors. Although the imagery of the painting are farmers working, I love how they get to at least work outside and enjoy the beautiful view of the mountains and green plains that God created. The second painting I've chosen to focus on is Jean-Francois Millet's Man with the Hoe, made in 1860 through 1862. Millet was born in 1814 and grew up in a rural countryside of France. He spent most of his childhood in extreme poverty, living among the working class peasants, which he used later as subjects for his paintings. When observing the painting, Man with the Hoe, the viewer sees a field worker as he leans over, clearly exhausted from his labors, his hands upon his hoe. His clothes are rough and dirty, his face careworn, as he stares blankly into the distance. The background of the painting is dry plains, covered with dirt, rocks, dried grass, and flowers. Deep in the background towards the right center, we see another peasant working, plucking at the dirt with the hoe, creating dust to rise. The painting overall captures the day in life of a peasant working in the hot fields in the 1860s, which seemed overall unpleasant. Millet did a fantastic job creating element to the painting by having space, color, and value. The spacing in the painting shows the focus, which is the peasant in distress from working hours of hard labor. There is also spacing between another worker from a far distance, which shows isolation in the painting. The color of the painting used were dense colors, like brown, not giving the painting as much light. This makes the painting distressed. Overall, the value of the painting did not have bright colors, which makes the viewer interpret the artwork to be sorrowful. What I derive from Millet's Man with the Hoe is how labor work is distressful by working long hours in the hot sun. By the look of the peasant's distraught face and him leaning his weight against his hoe, this shows how tired and exhausted he is from working. This painting makes me feel sorrow and empathetic for these hard labor peasant workers. In conclusion, both art pieces portray work from the late 1800s and both provide different emotions. Segantini's work gives a sense of joyful imagery by providing an appealing view of the mountains, green grass, blue skies, and bright colors. Millet's artworks gives a sense of distress through the colors, background of dirt, isolation between people, and the peasant's emotion/stance. Both artworks are culturally significant as they capture a moment in history to express meaning, which gives a viewer a sense of time travel to feel that they're in that moment in time. Lastly, both artworks enrich our understanding of the world because it gives a viewer a life lesson as they interpret the art to their own life experiences.